Okay, first understand what exactly it means when somebody says, controlling the mind. See, thoughts cannot be controlled. But how we respond to those thoughts, how we respond to a situation, that can be improved. Control over that can be improved. It depends basically, certain situation has happened. So are you reacting to the situation or you are acting on that situation? Because reaction is always negative. But with proper training of the mind, it is possible that instead of reacting, you started basically more and more acting. You more and more basically you can take a well-informed, balanced decision. You can take a proper action. So instead of reaction, you can take a proper action. See, let's understand in a practical way. Sometimes somebody says, "Oh, whenever I see this person, he just drives me crazy." So this person is essentially saying that he or she has got absolutely no control over his or her mind. Because if this person basically can drive you crazy, that means you are actually reacting. That's a reaction. Now, let's basically move further how we can improve or how we can control the mind or how we can control the way we respond to certain situations or certain thoughts. Some people basically suggest like with the yoga and pranayama, you can improve or you can control the mind. Not exactly. Hatha yoga basically can help you to physically physical well-being better. Hatha yoga can also help you to release the stress and make you more calm. Yes, that's true. Likewise, pranayama basically can make you make your mind even more calmer. That's true. But not controlling the mind. Or not the way basically you can control. It can help you to basically become much more calm, so you can basically become little bit better for the time being when you just finish this yoga session or pranayama session for some time. It can help you basically mind become much more calmer. But what exactly happens is that, for example, in our deeper, very deep, at very deep state of our subconscious mind, there are a lot of impurities are there. And when those basically impurities comes up, and if you're not exactly regularly training your mind, it is very much possible that its impurities can overpower your mind and you can actually lose the control of the mind. If somebody says that, what is the stage basically where a person has absolute control over their mind, I would say that stage is a highest stage or highest stage of a human development. And that stage basically human is almost like, or not almost, actually human is like a god. The concept of god which we have in our mind, human basically becomes that god, that concept, that where basically he has got absolute control of the mind. I mean, I will give you an example. It is not exactly, but quite near to that. For example, you take the concept of a Jesus, that gentleman basically is crucified. He has been tortured to death. And even at that particular last moment, he's having a thought that, "A God, please do not punish these people who are torturing me because they don't know what they're doing." So imagine the state of the mind, the physically crucified, so much torture, but he has got fully, full control how he's responding to that outside situation. He's got full control over that. And his control basically he's got full of compassion, full of love. So this person basically, you can say that, almost like, very high level, or almost you can say that control over the mind, that even at the torturous stage, he's having the control that he is not leaving his true nature, which was of love and compassion. So the methodology to have a better control over the mind, or you can say better responding to the situation, is Number one, you have to get rid of impurities in our own mind. That deep-rooted impurities, which is lying deeper into the subconscious mind, you have to get rid of them. And second, basically, of course, daily practice, where you become more and more conscious, you become more and more aware of what is happening inside. And you started observing. You can see that deep-rooted impurities are coming. For example, anger is coming and you're observing. And then basically, anger goes away. So likewise, layers of angers goes away. So layers of impurities goes away. So the more and more you develop the ability to observe with equanimity, and more basically deep-rooted impurities are going out of your mind, more and more control you started having over your mind, or I will say more and more control you will have how you respond to certain unpleasant situation, or how you respond to unpleasant environment or unpleasant people you met in your life.